गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विथ द टॉपिक फीचर्स फॉर्म्ड इन डिफरेंट स्टेजेस ऑफ रिवर. इन योर प्रीवियस क्लास आई होप यू पीपल रिमेंबर दैट आई अंडरलाइन सर्टेन पॉइंट्स सच एज सोर्स ऑफ रिवर, माउथ, डेल्टा, लैंड फॉर्म्स एक्सेट्रा. ओके, सो दीज ऑल थिंग्स एज वेल एज योर meanders and oxbow lakes. What all are these types of formations that we will study just now in features formed in different stages of the river. Starting with meander. First of all, let's see what it is given in this particular paragraph. In the plains, the river moves leisurely, means freely. Meaning of leisurely will be what? Freely. And its course forms broad S-shaped loops or curves. These curves are called meanders. Okay. I hope you people are able to see this particular portion. Okay. Here, rivers are coming in a plain area and there are no boundations for these rivers. So, what is happening? They take a natural S-like formation. Okay. So, in this S-like, you can see there is one loop over here and another loop over here. Okay. So, this is only your what? Meander. Let me illustrate you people more clearly in my notebook. Okay. When a river flow in a plain area, they usually take broad S-shaped loops like structure in this manner. Okay, in this manner they take broad S-like loop structure. So here you can see this particular portion as well as this particular portion. Okay, so this together it is known as what? Your meander. Clear? And let me remind you, this particular thing happens in second stage of river. This is the important thing. Okay, means the meander formation occurs in second stage of river. Now coming back to the chapter, when the course of rivers lies in a flat land, the irregularities of ground forces the river to swing from one side in a wide bends and forms. The word meander is used to describe a winding pattern of Biyuk meanders rivers in Turkey. If you people are able to see this figure 1.24 as well as figure 1.23, okay, what it is given? A meandering river and formation of an oxbow lake. Now what is an oxbow lake? Here only it will be clear to you. Understood? Now in this particular thing, what it is given over here? When the courses of the river lies in a flat land, the irregularities of ground force the river to swing from side to side in a wide bends and forms. Means the thing is very simple. Our land is not completely straight like our notebook, like a, you know, this particular notebook. It is completely flat. Okay, if you are going to pour a water over here, it is not going to take either this type of formation or oxbow lake. It will flow freely. But our land is not completely flat like our notebook or like our piece of paper. Okay, there are certain irregularities. Means if there are somewhere mountains, so it will become over here plain. Sometimes it will go like this way manner also. Okay, so what happens? The rivers flow according to the shape of the land. Understood? River flows according to the shape of the land. So this is only helps in the formation of meander. That is only the thing. Okay, and here it is given the example of meander, that is Biyuk meanders river in Turkey in Eurasia. You can see how much broadly this particular thing is formed. Okay, it looks like a snake, a movement of a snake. Clear? So this was your meander. Now the turn of Oxbow Lake. Sometimes what happens when these rivers, okay, are forming broader loops of S like this manner. Okay, broader loops of S like this manner, sometimes what happens due to continuous flow of water, as you can see it over here like this way, continuous flow of water, this particular portion is basically your land portion, okay, and this which I am showing with the help of arrow, this is the basically direction of river. Now how this Oxbow Lakes form? Sometimes what happens, due to continuous flow of water, this land area starts getting compressed, means the land area starts getting reduced in its shape. So what happens, by coming like this manner, then coming more closer to each other, then coming more closer to each other, at last what happens, it completely gets touched like this manner, okay, and rest of the river starts flowing from here only, and it is completely left alone. Understood? So what happens, it forms like a lake over here, okay, and this particular area becomes completely, which I am shading over here, it is a land area. The land area over here got shrunked, got submerged according to the flow of river. Okay, so distance over here starts getting reduced due to continuous flow of water, and at last what happens, it gets submerged, it gets joined towards itself. Okay, and now if you are seeing this particular thing here, this shape you are seeing, this particular shape, this is only known as what? Oxbow Lake. Why? Because it is no more flowing. What is the speciality of a river and what is the speciality of a lake? In a river, water always flows. In a river, water always flows. Okay? And in a lake, water becomes stagnant. Stagnant means what? Ek jagah thehra hua, which cannot move itself on its own. It is present over there. It cannot be moved now. Okay? So the lake water which becomes stagnant, that's your Oxbow Lake. A river where water is always flowing, this is that particular portion. Now I hope you people have understood how is this the formation of Oxbow Lake. If you are seeing it over here, you can see the flow of the river. See, it is given with the help of arrow, and this shady area you are seeing, that is basically your land area. Okay, see how it is getting reduced over here, then ultimately what happens, it gets submerged, okay, and the direction of river changes itself. So what happens to this particular area? It remains over here forever, okay, not forever basically, but it remains over here for a quite long period of time, and if the volume of water is very less, it dries up during summer season, okay, and it is left like this manner only. So this is all about your meander and Oxbow Lake formation. Coming to the next topic, that is your tributaries. I hope you people remember what I have told you regarding tributaries, how tributaries are formed. Okay, I told you in my last class that when a parent river, okay, means the main river channel, okay, divides itself for a very first time, So this is only known as what? Your tributary. Clear? Now this, let's see what else is given over here. A tributary is a stream or a river that flows into a larger stream or a main stream or a parent river or a lake. A tributary does not flow directly into a sea or ocean. This is a very important point which is needed to be noted down. Okay, I given here a star mark because this thing is important. Okay, now next thing what it is given over here, tributaries and main rivers drain the surrounding drainage basin of its surface water and groundwater, leading the water out to an ocean. A confluence where two or more bodies of water meet, it refers to the joining of tributaries. Now, what happens sometimes? Let me show you with the help of a diagram. Please look over here carefully. Now, this is the main river channel. Okay, I'm writing down over here as main river. Okay, and due to presence of some, either you can say a hill or a mountain or a plateau or any sort of landforms, main river was unable to go from it, means over, clear, over from it. Now what it has done, it has separated its ways like this manner. Okay, now it will change its direction. Why? Because this bigger thing is present over here in the middle. So here the river is dividing itself for the first time. So what it is? Your tributary. Clear? Now it is just not the end. What happens? Possibility is there that there will be some plain area in between. Then again there will be a hilly area. Then again there will be a plain area or a down area. So what thing is happening? It's keep on dividing. Suppose if in this particular portion there is one landscape, okay, or if there is one more particular portion of landscape in middle, so what will happen? Again this river will divide itself like this manner. Again it will divide itself like this manner. Okay, so it forms like a tree branch, first over here like this way, then over here like this way, then again it will divide itself, then again it will re-divide itself like this manner. Okay, but there will be a point. Okay students, there will be one point when these all particular thing will meet at one point before going into ocean. Okay, before going into ocean there will be one point where these all river tributaries and distributaries will meet once again before going to the ocean. So this particular point is only known as what? Your confluence. In your book also this example is very clearly given. If you see this particular figure 1.25, it is written a Hart River is a tributary of Missouri River in USA. See, from here this particular river is coming. Clear? Now due to the arrangement of the landscape it has divided itself. Here also, as you can see, it has redivided itself into many branches. Then at last what it is happening, it is coming and joining at one particular point. This particular point you people are seeing, this is only what? Your confluence. Okay, so this is all about your tributaries. Then comes the next topic, that is your distributary. When sediments build up alone the river's main channel, the channel gets blocked and river is forced to divide into branches called distributaries. Distributary is a river or a stream that branches off the main stream and flows away. Distributaries are most often found in a river deltas. The phenomenon of distributary is known as river bifurcation. Now let me tell you what it is given over here. The next topic was what? Distributaries. Now in order to understand this particular topic, let me take you back at the beginning of this 10th topic where we have discussed the three stages of river, the first stage, the second stage and the third stage. In first stage, I told you regarding originating of a river from a mountain. Okay, here you might remember I have told you that your river is narrow and speed is high. So what happens when a river is narrow and speed is high, whatever comes in between the path of this river, this river is having the tendency to carry it with itself. Okay, it could be some soil particles or some small rocks, branches of trees, leaves, etc. Since the speed is very high, it will carry it with itself. Okay, because it is coming with a very great speed, so whatever will come in between, it will carry with itself. Now, as it is coming to the plain area, sometimes what happens, the river is unable to carry it further. Why? Because here the breadth starts getting broadening itself. Okay, it becomes what? Broader. And speed becomes what? Speed is slow. Okay, since the speed is slow, what happens, it is having the tendency of leaving those things in between, like this way. Okay, and this is only one main reason why river is forced to distribute itself. Okay, because continuous deposition of this particular thing in the middle of a river, like this manner. So it bifurcates itself or it distributes itself. Clear? Now, since you know the flow of a river is a continuous process, it is not the thing that once it has flowed, here it will become dry. No, it is a continuous process, it is a cyclic process, it will happen continuously. So what will be the outcome? The sediment depositions over here will become bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Okay, sometimes it could happen over here, and sometimes after following certain more paths, it could appear here also, and it could appear here also. And this will be the another reason why it will bifurcate itself again, or why it will divide itself again. Why? Because it will be not able to go from it above. It is not possible. Iske upar se nahi ja sakta. So what will happen? It will go from sideways direction. It will go through sideways. It will take its paths along the side direction. So this is only what given over here regarding your distributaries. And this phenomenon or this process is only known as what? Your river bifurcation. I hope you people have understood this particular topic. Now we will come to the next topic, that is your delta. As the river nears the sea or ocean towards the end of its journey, its course is blocked by its own deposits, forming a fan-shaped alluvial deposits called delta. The word delta, which originated from the Greek letter delta, closely resembles the triangular delta of Nile. Due to the obstruction caused by deposited alluvium, the river discharges its water through several channels called distributaries, example Hooghly River. Now here what it is written, river nears the sea or ocean towards the end of its journey, its course is blocked by its own deposits. I am highlighting this particular thing, that its course is blocked by its own deposits. So what will be the meaning of it? I hope you people remember just now what I have said regarding your first stage of a river. When the river is narrow and the speed is high, it is having the tendency to carry all its deposits. Okay, the residue or the material from the mountain and whatever is the distance she is traveling. Okay, she carries all the deposits with herself. Okay, the place where it is unable to carry it further longer, it deposits over there. It keep it over there and she moves forward. Okay, so दिस थिंग इज ओनली हैपनिंग इन डेल्टा. दिस थिंग ओनली हैपन्स इन डेल्टा. वॉट हैपन्स हियर आई एम डायरेक्टली ड्रॉइंग बाय द डिस्ट्रीब्यूटरीज. ओके, हियर इज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूटरी, हियर इज अगेन योर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटरीज, हियर अगेन, हियर अगेन, हियर अगेन, हियर अगेन. ओके, एज यू कैन सी देयर आर मेनी न्यूमरस टाइप्स ऑफ चैनल्स हैव फॉर्म्ड राइट नाउ एंड दिस इज योर ओशियन. Now what will happen or why this thing is happening? Because here this delta formation, okay, this delta formation happens in the last stage of river formation, last stage of river formation. Last stage was what? Your third stage. And what was the thing given over here regarding it? It's an old age. Since this particular area, if you people are able to make out here, these particular portions are basically your land area. So from where this land portion area is coming, it is nothing but the deposits. It is nothing but the deposits everywhere. You, these things you are able to see everywhere. This particular thing is nothing but your deposits. Since river is in its last stage, third stage, and it is old as well. So what will happen? The deposits or the alluvium, it will be unable to carry with itself. So what it will do? It will deposits here and there, it will deposit it here and there. Okay, wherever the land surface will be little bit higher, it will deposit its alluvium at that particular place and it will move forward, and at last where it will go? It will go and meet in the ocean. Just for your example, you can see in your book this particular thing you are seeing. Okay, I am focusing this particular portion, figure 1.26. See, here the main channel of the river, clear? Main channel of the river coming together, bifurcating itself. See it? And this areas you are seeing, this land portion, this is basically the deposits from the river, which is carried from a very long distance. Clear? Now see it over here, main river, tributaries over here, then distributaries. This dot dot area you are seeing, these are nothing but what? Deposition. What deposition? Alluvium. What was this alluvium? This alluvium was nothing but the fertile soil which is brought up by this main river from the point of its origination, from where this river was originated. This river was originated from mountains, especially snow covered mountains. Clear? I hope this thing is clear. Now let's see what else is given about your delta. Some deltas are extremely large. Example, Ganga Brahmaputra is almost as big as whole of West Malaysia. Deltas differ much in their size, shape, growth and importance. A number of factors such as the rate of sedimentation, depth of the river, the seabed, the character of tides. What is tides? Basically sea waves. High tides, low tide, high sea waves, low sea waves. It happens due to the gravitational pull of sun and moon. Okay, currents which flows beneath the level of sea. Okay, it happens at the surface of sea. Your tide occurs at the surface of sea, current occurs below the surface of the sea. Okay, when you people will go to your higher classes, this word will come again and it will be explained to you in very great detail. And waves greatly influence the formation of deltas. So this was all about your deltas. Okay, then we are coming to the Next topic, that is your anticlines and synclines. In order to understand this thing, first thing you should know that what is anticline and what is a syncline. Okay, here it is given. Before reading this particular thing, I will read out first of all this particular portion. The arched or upraised part of a fold are called anticline. Syncline is a downward fold, or an inverted anticline is known as syncline. Let me show you with the help of a diagram which is already given over here in figure 1.29, anticline and syncline. See this third diagram. Syncline, which is downward portion. Anticline, which is upward portion. Now question arises, how this thing is happening? Okay, how this thing is happening? Now here it is illustrated with the help of diagram, this 1 and 2, and here it is written something about your anticline and synclines. So let's study it and let's see what it is given. Anticline and syncline are terms associated with the folding of a rock strata. During the process of folding, folds are formed in earth crust due to compression. The arc or upraised of the folds are known as anticlines, and a syncline is a downward fold or an inverted anticline. Here it is written, during the process of folding, folds are formed in earth crust due to compression. The question arises, what is compression? When force of earth, okay, when force of earth comes towards each other, okay, coming towards each other like this manner, okay, from here to here it is coming towards each other. What is the what basically happens? The land area tends to fold itself, and due to this compression only mountains are formed. Formation of mountain, compression, this activity is having a major role in formation of this particular mountain. We are unable to notice it. Why? Because this process is a very slow process. Okay, let me show you with the help of one more illustration. Suppose this piece of paper, okay, suppose this piece of paper is your land area. Clear? This particular portion is your land area, and if you are able to see my right hand and my left hand, okay, I am holding this page from its very extreme right edge as well as from your left edge. What will happen if I will try to draw my hands little bit closer to each other? You are able to see? What will happen if I am drawing my hands a little bit closer to each other? The thing is very common. Let me explain you once again. As I was saying, please focus in my right hand as well as on my left hand. If I am holding this piece of a paper, okay, and try to compress it from both the side, or if I am applying certain force to one side, what is happening? Now I will show you the side view of this particular thing. If you are able to see, it is folded from certain portion. Okay, why? Because I have applied the force in same direction, not in the opposite direction, same direction, towards one direction. Okay, and if you are able to see, there was certain portion which was folded down, and there was certain portion which was folded up. So the upward folded portion was your anticline, and downward folded portion was what? Your syncline. Okay, so this is how your anticline and syncline formation occurs due to the help of one force, that is known as what? Your compression. Okay, so I hope with this illustration it is clear to you people. Now coming back to the chapter, As you can see over here, it is once again very nicely illustrated with the help of diagram. This is see figure one, figure number one. Okay, here due to compression force, here see the land is completely straight with no force applied to it. And when in the second thing, the fold is applied, see the fold is formed right now over here like this manner. Okay, so upward folding portion is your anticline and downward portion is your what? Syncline. Okay, these three diagrams are very important, students. At the time of notes, you need to draw this diagram in your notebook. Clear? Then comes your last topic, that is your block mountains. Okay, these mountains were formed when the mass of land was pushed up between parallel cracks or fault in the earth's crust or by sinking of the land around them. These mountains are usually steep-sided and flat-topped. The typical example of block mountain is seen in the Black Forest to the east of Rhine River on the border between the France and Germany. Now, I will explain it to you with help of one more illustration. Students, as you can see, I have arranged a piece of candle, okay, in order to illustrate how block mountains are formed. Okay, I hope a slight cracks is visible in this particular candle. Okay, the cracks which is developed on earth, it is also known as your what? Fault line. Okay, now what happens when the force is applied to the opposite direction? Let me tell you, when the force is applied to the opposite direction, there only your block mountain formation occurs. So what happens? Now see it. As you can see that I have broken this candle into three pieces, okay, and I have tried to join it. Same thing happens in your earth also. Okay, there are numerous cracks which is known as fault lines is available in our earth. So due to this forces, what happens? You just see it. As you can see that if I am trying to raise this to a certain height and if I am removing my hands towards opposite direction, as you can see that the extreme right hand side and extreme left hand side portion will remain intact to this position, and the portion which was there in the middle, it has slided downward. Okay, showing it to you once again, here it is like this manner and it is going in downward direction. So how it is happening when I am pulling my both hands away from each other? Okay, just see it. Pulling my hands away from each other. So this is the manner how your block mountains are formed. So which will be your block mountain? Block mountain will be your left hand side as well as your right hand side portion. Okay, if this particular portion is further divided into cracks, okay, then it will be more clearly visible. You just see it how nicely it is sliding down when the forces is applied to the opposite direction. Okay, so this is how your block mountains are formed. So this becomes your rock strata. My right hand becomes your rock strata. The block which has gone down, it is known as block subsided. Block subsided means what? The block which is sliding down. Understood? And this particular portion is your what? Block mountain. So I hope this illustration was helpful for you people. Now, the thing which I demonstrated with the help of candle, it is also given in this particular diagram. Now see it here, fault line means a crack. Clear? Now here it is written block mountain, block subsided and rock strata. Means what? This particular portion was this middle portion of the candle which has slided down. Here subsided means what? Slided. Clear? So this is all about your block mountain. I hope this particular portion is clear. So by this topic we come to end of our this particular chapter. Now, some information regarding your exercises as well as notes. There were certain notes which I have given you during my lecture period. So, that notes as well as this exercise. As you can see, this exercise is having many questions, 6 questions altogether. Okay, and let me remind you, this particular question number E, which it is written, identify and draw the given figure and label it. This particular portion is not there in your syllabus. It is omitted from your syllabus. So you don't have to do this particular question. Now the exercise portion, your tick the correct answer and fill in the blanks. These two particular things will be done in your book itself. Okay, the answers will be also given to you. And regarding the things which you need to do in your notebook, that is your explain the following term, give reason, differentiate between, and answer in brief. Okay, these all particular portions, and there are certain diagrams as well. There are some important notes which you need to do in your notebook. So this particular portion will be available on our school website, that is your www.lfsraptinagar.ac.in, in the download section. Okay, reminding you once again, www.lfsraptinagar.ac.in in download section. You can go and download this important notes as well as your question answers by Thursday. It will be uploaded to that website by Thursday. On Thursday, you can go and note down all your important notes as well as your question answers of this particular chapter. I hope this chapter is clear now, and I hope you people enjoyed studying this very first chapter. Meet you in the next session. Till then, thank you so much.